So, good morning, everyone. Thanks for your time. So today, I'd like to introduce you to our company, Gumi, first. And then I'm going to talk about what we are doing to be a number one in each market. And we are a mobile gaming company. And I believe we are one of the fastest growing company in the mobile space right now in the world. And then this happy face guy is our CEO. So he's a very unique guy. So he graduated university in China and then United States. And he speaks three languages. And he's a very visionary guy and then leads company very well. And then this is our company vision. We are trying to be number one digital entertainment company in the world. And then corporate principle. So I personally like it, like fast to try, fast to fail, and fast to recover. So we keep challenging. Then even we fail, we just recover immediately. And we are just doing this cycle very quickly. And then we think globally and act locally. I will talk more about this later. And since 2012, we established 8 studio from scratch just in 2 years. I was kind of in charge with. And I left the company, the venture company with Fuji TV, who is a huge TV broadcasting company in Japan. And then we are making a game and then try to do the multimedia promotion with them. And these are our actual studios in the world. So each studio performs all functions like development and publishing and BD and marketing. So our number of employees total is 800. And then we are also establishing a studio in Austin and Vancouver now. And these are our the board members. We have a kind of dandy CEO and then spiky hair CFO. And then the handsome guy, the light is me. By the way, I'm in charge of the global business development. And like I said, I'm a CEO of Korea. And these guys are the head of a studio. And then everyone is pretty talented and very experienced in each country. And then this is actually our history. So we originally started mobile SNS service, but it didn't go well. And then we started to the mobile social gaming development on Gumi platform, although these are feature phone and web games. But it's really successful. And then we become one of top developer on the Gumi platform. And then we first made our big fundraising end of 2011. But mid of 2012, the people started to replacing feature phones with smartphone, and then we lost tons of users and sales. And then we have to do the big transition to make the native apps. It was actually a hard time for us, but fortunately, we made one of the successful titles called the Brave Frontier in Japan. And we made another hit title in Korea. And then we launched the Brave Frontier in North America end of 2013. And then we made another fundraising end of 2013 as well. And then this month, we also announced a $50 million fundraising. And we made a publishing deal with Sega for the North American publishing. We actually so happy, so excited. This is our current status. Then this is our funding history. So we raised about almost $100 million total. And then that is a very unique record in venture companies in Japan. And this is our business model. We develop our own IP title as well as a licensed IP title. And then we do we publish external companies' games in global. We do actually everything. And then let me just show you briefly our developed title. These are our web games. Most of the titles are very successful, although the all games are card battle games. So as you probably know, a couple of years ago in Japan, I don't know personally why, but Japanese users only play card battle games. And these are the IP license title, then also very successful. And native games. So Brave Frontier, we've launched in 55 countries now, and then we are successful most of those countries. And these are other major native titles. So we operate many types of games, like RPG, and sports game, and shooting game, and puzzle games. And these Korean titles reached 3 million downloads in a short amount of time, and very, very successful because of my studio. And upcoming titles. So we are preparing over 30 new games in the world, and some multiple titles are coming to United States as well. And then one of these titles in the United States is a Chain Chronicle from the Sega. So we are so excited and so happy to publish this game in the United States. Then we also made another publishing deal with huge IP title called Wakufu. So this IP is developed by the famous French company Ankama. And we're actually talking with another huge IP titles right now. Sorry. So now I will share with what we learned and then what we are doing to be a number one in each market. So lessons from Brave Frontier. So as you know, we launched 55 countries, and then we found out a lot of differences in each countries. Then one is the local infrastructure, like our environment, and then another is our user behavior. So first, so as you can see, imagine the network connectivity is really different in each countries. So for example, if you are in Japan or US, you only see the like a 4G or 3G in your mobile screen as a signal indicator. But if you go to China or some other Southeast Asian countries, you see like E, you know the E? I don't know what the E means too, but maybe empty or something. But quite low connectivities, you know. But what you actually have to be concerned about is your file download size. Because you have to divide your apps download size and download them as a user progress in the games each time. Otherwise, users just leave your game some low connectivity countries. And other things is OS penetration is totally different in other countries. For example, in Korea, so over 90% is the Android because of Samsung. And then some countries are still using a very, very old phone, which you are not cannot find in your countries. But you also have to deeply concern about this issue. Otherwise, you are going to lose your business opportunities in some countries. And the next is user behavior. So you have to consider the user lifestyle and demographic. For example, the majority of Japanese users play the mobile games in while commuting time, like train or bus, because the transportation is very advanced in Japan. That means users prefer to play games in short amount of times, like 5 minutes or so. But in the US, the people play games in the house, like before they go to bed. That means you can provide like the games such as a longer time period games. And you can also think about gaming history, because we just found out this one lately. So like Japan and Western countries, so console games are popular since about 30 years ago. That means you can reach out a wide age range of users. But in China, in Korea, there are no console games. But they played PC online games since about 15 years ago. But that means it might be difficult to reach out to older people who are not familiar with the games. But like I said, popular games and game mechanics is actually different among those countries. So you might be able to consider how to adjust your games for each country. And this is the result of the Brave Frontier. So we actually made a major and a minor changes for Brave Frontier. This is the main reason why we perform very well in each country. Like this. Are we still optimizing European countries? And the key factors to global success. So these are actually we are focusing on to be number one in each market. The one is our global development and publishing. And two, the region-specific marketing. And three, the local partner network. And four, global legal team. And then five, the community management. And global development and publishing. So each studio that makes games for local market, and then we believe local people just know the local market the best. Of course, yes, right? That's why we collect the best local people, then they do the culturalization. And marketing. We also deeply into local marketing. We are not only doing the typical standard global online marketing, but also doing local marketing, like a TV commercial, a survey ads, and exhibition, and a lot of some other things with local. And we also have a strong BD team in each studio, and they handle deals with local companies. Like these companies, we have already made the deals. And legal, we have a strong global legal team that because as you can imagine, the law and regulations are totally different in each country. That's why we need the legal team. And community management. So each local studio handles community management. And we try to be more interactive with local users because we provide a service. And then we have to listen to users' voices very carefully. I think this is very important to be more local. Actually, that's about it. So I just talked about our experience very briefly. If you want to talk about more detail, please just get in touch with me. And then we, if you want to publish your games through us, also get in touch with us. And then you are hiring. Yeah. Thank you.